Assalamu alaikum. In this video we will discuss the anti-diabetics. But first we will discuss what is diabetes mellitus. In this video we will discuss only the diabetes mellitus 2. Here you can see this is the stomach, this is intestine, this is pancreas. What happens normally when we uptake the food, then glucose enters the small intestine. From the small intestine it is absorbed into the blood. Inside the blood it reaches when the pancreas, then it causes the stimulation of the B cells of pancreas to release the insulin. Now what happens in diabetes mellitus? In diabetes mellitus there is insulin resistance. Therefore the levels of glucose are increased in the body and it leads to B cell hypertrophy. These cells are atrophied. This leads to B cell atrophy and failure to release the insulin. To treat this diabetes mellitus type 2, we use different types of medications. If B cells do not produce any insulin in case of diabetes mellitus, then we use insulin injections to treat the patients. These insulin injections are given to treat the diabetes mellitus. But if B cells are able to produce some insulin, then we give the medications. The first group of drugs that we give to treat the diabetes mellitus are biguanides. Biguanides include metformin, one of the most important drug that is used to treat diabetes mellitus. It is the drug of choice to treat diabetes mellitus type 2. What it does with the body? It increases the insulin sensitivity. So it increases the glucose uptake by the liver cells and by the muscle cells. Furthermore, it decreases the glucogenolysis in the liver. Glucogenolysis in the liver is inhibited and it decreases the appetite. These all things lead to decrease in the levels of glucose in the body. Side effects of biguanides. The side effects of biguanides are GIT upsets, anorexia and lactic acidosis. So this drug is contraindicated in the patients with liver failure and renal failure. Now we will come to the next class of drugs. These are also the one of the most important drugs that are used in the treatment of diabetes mellitus type 2. These are sulfonylureas. The examples of sulfonylureas are glipizide, glycyrrhizide, glyburide and glimepiride, chlorpromazine, etc. These drugs stimulate the B cells by inhibiting the release of potassium from the cell. And therefore, more and more insulin is released, and therefore, diabetes mellitus is treated. So, sulfonylureas stimulate B cells to release insulin. The adverse effects of sulfonylureas include hypoglycemia. That is obvious because when more insulin is released, then it can lead to hypoglycemia, and these drugs also lead to weight gain. The next group of drugs that we will discuss here are thiazolidinediones. Thiazolidinediones include रोसिग्लिटाजोन एंड पायोग्लिटाजोन. दिस थायाजोलिडिन डायोन्स इंक्रीज द इंसुलिन सेंसिटिविटी एंड देयर फॉर अपटेक ऑफ ग्लूकोज इज इंक्रीज्ड एंड देयर फॉर लेवल्स ऑफ ग्लूकोज इन द बॉडी आर डिक्रीज्ड. फर्दर मोर इट डिक्रीजेज द फ्री फैटी एसिड रिलीज फ्राम द एडिपोज टिश्यू. दैट इज फ्री फैटी एसिड रिलीज फ्राम द एडिपोज टिश्यू इज डिक्रीज्ड. द एडवर्स इफेक्ट्स ऑफ थायाजोलिडिन डायोन्स इंक्लूड अनिमिया, कंजेस्टिव हार्ट फेलियर एंड एडिमा. द नेक्स्ट ड्रग क्लास वी विल डिस्कस आर glucosidase inhibitors. To understand their mechanism, first we will discuss what happens here. We will magnify this. Here we have magnified this area. You can see this is lumen of the intestine and this is the epithelial cell. Normally there are triosis and oligosaccharides in the intestine that should be degraded to monomer, that is glucose, by this alpha glucosidase enzyme. This glucose then can enter the intestinal epithelial cell and is absorbed into the blood. What these drugs do? These drugs inhibit this enzyme and therefore absorption of glucose is inhibited. Example of this drug is acarbose and the other drug is meglitol. These drugs decrease the glucose absorption. Adverse effects of these drugs include flatulence, cramps and diarrhea. Now we will discuss the next class of drugs. The next class of drugs is GLP-1 analogs. These drugs bind with the GLP-1 receptors. These GLP-1 receptors are when stimulated, then release of insulin is increased and these also decrease the appetite and increase the levels of glucagon. And in this way, the levels of glucose in the body are decreased because more insulin is released, it decreases the levels of glucose in the body. When appetite is decreased, then obviously the levels of glucose are less in the body and glucagon release is also decreased, not increased but decreased. Glucagon levels are when decreased, then conversion of glycogen into glucose is decreased. The adverse effects of these drugs include headache, muscle weakness and others, and these are contraindicated in type 1 diabetes mellitus and diabetic ketoacidosis. Examples of GLP-1 analogs include lead. To remember the drugs, liraglutide, exenatide, and dulaglutide, etc. This is all about the drugs that are used in the treatment of diabetes mellitus. Thank you for watching.